What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Travis. Of course, this is TWA Motorsports, and today, yes, we are working on the Tahoe. Now, a couple people have asked, have you ever thought about installing a system in anything? And to be quite honest with you guys, I used to do that in all my vehicles, but today we're going to be putting something in the Suburban. I got these speakers used, and to be honest with you guys, used is almost the best way to buy this stuff because it just is worth nothing used. So you can pick stuff up relatively cheap. They don't actually even make these anymore. These are Solo Classics. So Solo Barrick back in the day, they actually used to be circles, and then they came out with this Solo Classic probably about, I don't even know, probably 6 or 7 years ago, maybe even longer. But that is what these are, and this is in a preformed kicker box. And normally I would have something custom built or make my own box, but to be honest with you guys, I don't really have time for that, and I just want a little bit more bass. So I have a buddy that was selling these, and so I decided to pick them up. 200 bucks is what I spent for them. Really cheap, especially since it's all ready to go. Also, I have had these amps. I actually have three of these amps that I've had for probably about, I don't know, 8 years as well. And I just keep them in storage. And so I put one in my old 52 Chevy. That's what runs the subs in that. And then I'm gonna put one in here, and I still have another one. So maybe at some point I might put one in the old car. And then if I end up doing something with, if I don't sell the two-door Tahoe, I will make a custom system for it. But the only things I actually had to buy, I actually had this from an old Tahoe before. This is a line converter, so we can tap in to the factory radio, because I am gonna leave it for now. And it's kind of cool because it does have an adjustment knob, so you can turn it up and down if you want to not listen to bass. And we're gonna install that. And then the only thing I really bought new is wire. And I just bought a kit, and I'll list it down below. It's just a kicker kit, 4-gauge wire, I think, what's this, 12-gauge probably, speaker leads, and then it comes with your RCAs, it comes with the fuse and fuse holder, and then it comes with the amp turn on, and then a couple screws and zip ties. But we're gonna get started. I'm going to show you guys the process that I'm going to use to put this in, because I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the amp under the seat back here. So I'm gonna put it right here, I believe. So it's out of the way. We actually never even flip this up. When people get in the back, they just crawl through the center. So I'm gonna put the amp there, and then we're obviously gonna have to tap into the radio. Yeah, I'm trying to think of what I'm talking about. So we're gonna have to take the center console at least up the center part here so we can get to the access. You don't wanna tap in the back, because on the Bose system, they actually cross over the speakers for the rear, so you're not going to get a ton of bass if you try to tap into a rear speaker. I know it's way easier, but believe me, I've done this in the past, and it will not sound good if you do that. So we need to tap in before it crosses that over, and I'll show you guys where that's at in this video. But I think the first thing I'm going to do is we're going to hook that up. So I'm going to pop this loose. I'll show you guys, like I said, the process, and well, let's get started. So the very first thing I'm going to do is, my panel tools are actually, I don't know where, they're actually behind my Corvette and I can't get to them. Problems that I need to get the shop finished for. So we're going to pop this out. Just snaps in. Once you get a side started, you could be careful and do it with a small flat blade screwdriver. Once we get that, there's a connection right here, and hopefully you guys are able to see it. I'm going to try to push it out of this holder. Grab something else to push it out of there, but I'll move the camera where you guys can see it a little better. So this is the piece we're looking for, and it clips in here. I used my panel remover tools to get that. So this right here are the wires that we want to tap into. These, there's a green, a light green, and then I believe it's kind of a bluish color and a light blue. So those are the ones that we're wanting to tap into. So what I'm going to do is unplug this, and we're going to strip this wire back. And that is where our line converter is going to hook in. So once you have it unplugged, you want to push back, obviously, the plastic as much as you can, or I mean the electrical tape. And I'm going to cut through these. I don't have a stripper that actually strips a section of the wire. I really need to get one at some point. But I'm going to chop this completely off. Now I'm going to put it back on, but with the line converter in the line, obviously. So I'm gonna cut them right here so I have enough to strip and splice it back together. And obviously we'll solder all the connections. But for now, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this, and then we'll get that line converter in place. So at this point, ready to hook this thing up. Now I did go ahead and put some additional black on here. That's for the ground, and then some additional yellow. There's just not a lot of lead there. So I did solder those and use some heat shrink, but I'm not gonna be able to use heat shrink here because I don't have enough room. The other thing I did is I took that amp turn on from the kicker kit, and I went ahead and hooked it to the blue, which is on the back side of this box. And I'll list this box down below. Like I said, I've had it for a while, but we need to hook up this plug. So basically you have two darks and two lights, and they're green and blue, and your dark colors are actually your positive and the lighter are the negative. So that's what we're gonna hook up here. And it doesn't really matter which side you hook what to. So I'm gonna go dark blue to the gray, and then these have a black stripe on them that represents the negative. And I'm sure if you guys have hooked this stuff up before, you understand that. But we're gonna go ahead and hook this up. I probably won't show you guys that because it's too small of a space and the lighting's not real good there. So I'm gonna hook it up and go ahead and solder it all together, and we'll have this part done. And then at that point, we're gonna need to find a place to grab some power and a place to ground. So to gain some additional clearance, so I'm not trying to reach down there, I did unplug this, and this just swings, this piece right here just swings open, and then you can unplug it, and then I have way more room to work here. So it's kind of tight quarters, to be real honest with you. And anyway, like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and hook this up, and then we'll get it all tucked back in there. Like I said, we gotta find some power at some point. So at this point, you can see I got the plug back on, we are wired in, and everything is soldered and taped. I was able to use some heat shrink because I was able to go a little further down. So there's heat shrink under the tape. I just taped it up to make it look more factory. And if you ever want to take this out, you can honestly just chop this off and tape it up and you're good. I wish that I would have unhooked that earlier because I could have went a little further down. I wouldn't have had to work so close to the plug, which is kind of a pain, but we got it. So now we need to find some power and a ground. So what I'm hoping is I'm gonna look up the pins on this guy. I think we can probably get our power and ground from this. At least that's what I'm hoping. So I do have a meter that I can check it with. The problem with these retained accessory power cars is sometimes they randomly don't throw power and sometimes they do. So we'll just have to check it, and let me do a little research and I'll get back to you. This looks like a pretty good size ground as well as a power. So I don't know, I may be able to just test that with my meter here. So instead of tapping into this, like I said, I think I'm gonna pull my accessory power from down below. I've been using my phone as a flashlight here, but if you pull out, if you take your cover off, which has a plastic clip in it in the center, you can see the clip there. If you pull this guy off, the very top one here, if you pull that out, I don't think I'll be able to do it with two hands. Once I get it out, I'll show you where we're gonna tap into, and that will give us the accessory power that we need. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run the line all the way under the carpet here into the center console. So it should be pretty easy to do that. And like I said, I'll pull this out and then I'll show you where we're gonna tap in. So while I hate using these kind of taps, that's what I actually ended up using. You can see I have the yellow coming out. That's what's gonna go to the center console. And the pink wire on the bottom, so you can see the lock right here, this orange lock. So it's the very first one. So the first one's open. So it's the first wire that comes out is actually the positive. So it's the very top plug. So you unplug it. So I'm gonna wrap this all in tape now and make it look kind of nice. Like I said, I hate using these, but that's all I had, and I didn't really want to strip that particular wire. So not gonna hurt anything. It's just not my preferred method, to be honest with you. So I'm gonna go ahead, tape this up, and then we'll get that line. I won't show you guys me running this line. I'm gonna run it back under the carpet here so I can pull the carpet back, and then I can actually thread it up under the console and get to it and pull it through. So at this point, I think I'm gonna grab the ground on the airbag module. You can see it down here. I tested it a couple times, tested a couple different areas, and to be honest with you, that is a pretty solid ground. Wherever I moved it, it works. So just a 10 millimeter is all you need to take that nut off, and then I'm gonna put like a little eyelet underneath it and tie my ground in right there instead of trying to tap into this. It just seemed like this ground was pretty inconsistent. So once I do that, we can go ahead and button this up. I am going to try to thread the line for the amp turn on over kind of behind the console here, and I'm going to try to go under the carpet. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to probably take this seat out just to make life easier on me, and then I can reach up under the carpet and we'll start back here in the back. So I'm onto this side. I went ahead and pulled the trim off here that just pops out, and same thing here in the back. Now the cool thing is this carpet is just Velcroed down. It's actually a separate section for the centerpiece, but we do need to get this seat out of the way. And in order to do that, there is a Torx bit that goes here in the center, and then this pulls back and gives you access to the bolts that actually hold the plate in. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that out of the way, and then we'll have a little more room to work. So once you get that plate off, it's just a T30 is all it is. And then the carpet, like I said, it Velcros down to the ground. So I rolled the carpet back, and you have access to your 18 millimeter that you need to take the seat out. So I'm also gonna unplug this plug. This is just for, I believe, seat belt, to be honest with you, because these are not power folding seats. So if they were power folding, you might have a little more. And then if you have a bench, obviously it's a little more cumbersome because you have to take more out. But I'm gonna go grab these 18s, we'll get this out of the way, and then we'll have a nice clean surface to start with. The other cool thing is we have a great spot to ground right here for our amplifier, and we should be able to reach up under the carpet and get all our wires through. So a little bit of bad news. I was gonna take this seat out just because it makes running that wire a little easier, but this seat does not move forward or back. It goes up and down, it reclines, but for some reason the motor is not working to move it forward and back, which makes it kind of a pain. But what I did was I snuck it underneath here and then pulled this back and ran the wire underneath the console. So you can see it's kind of poking out back there. And the world's loudest motorcycle going by. Anyway, we've got it to right here. So at this point, I think I'll be able to pull this up and sneak my hand under the carpet here and get to it. But it's just not really the way I wanted to do it. I honestly wanted to take the seat, even if I could move it forward, it would make life a little easier. But that's the way it goes sometimes you're working on cars. So I think I'm gonna just pop this piece of plastic loose if I can and see if I can sneak it under where you can't see as much as possible. There may be a little section right here where you have to see it, just because I can't take the console out without taking the seat out. So kind of a pain, but I'll get this under here and then we'll move on to the amp. So actually, after I moved that piece of plastic, I was able to reach up there and you can't see any of the wire at all. So worked out really nice. I don't want that running underneath the seat, so I'm gonna bring it over the top once we get the seat back in place and I kind of figure out where I'm gonna put the amp. But I figured since I'm back here, I went ahead and took the back seat out. I'm going to run the speaker wire basically from right here underneath the carpet. I pulled this panel back, it's just clipped into place. And then I'm gonna tuck it underneath this piece of plastic right here. That way I don't have to take any of this stuff out. It's already cracked and weathered, and honestly, guys, I don't want to have to take that out. So I'm going to tuck it up here and then we'll run our wire. I'm completely fine with having a little bit of wire showing, and if I don't, I can cut a little slit in the carpet back there, reach up under and grab it. So I think I'm going to go ahead and route this wire next, the speaker wire. So I got the wire, you can see the speaker wire ran. I actually put the back seat back in, just tucked it up underneath here nice and tidy. So at this point I'm gonna have to drill a couple holes, and to be honest with you guys, you just need to make sure I'm not gonna mount the amp in the traditional fashion with screws, because I'm gonna use some Velcro on the back side of it. It's not gonna be moving around a bunch and it's kind of encapsulated under the seat, so I don't really think there's a need to do that, especially once it's sitting on carpet. Like I said, I'm gonna use some Velcro similar to this here. But what I've got is I've got to drill a hole to run the power wire. So what I'm planning on doing is I'm gonna drill it right here. Now if you look underneath, the muffler is actually really close to here. It's actually about right in this area. So I'm wanting to drill as close to this as possible. You wanna make sure that there's nothing underneath it. And the kit does come with a grommet to put into the floor, which is awesome because you can probably find a spot in the firewall up front, but I would rather do it this way. Then I can run the wire right up the frame rail and to the battery, which is on this side. So I'm gonna go ahead, drill a hole, and then we'll put the grommet in. So at this point, you can see I have everything for the most part ran back here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and lay the carpet back down. I'm probably gonna have to cut a section in the carpet for the wire to come through, but we're finished. So as far as getting holes drilled and wires ran and whatnot. Now we still have to run the wire to the front, and you can see I've got it coming in from the bottom. So I'll show you guys that, but back here, I'm gonna go ahead and start to put things back together. So it looks like pretty good placement here for the power wire. You can see the speaker wire I did run under the seat bracket. It is between the carpet and the padding, so we're fine. It's not gonna pinch it when we put it down. But at this point, all we need to do is we're gonna fold the carpet over, and then we're gonna deal with all this wiring mess. But yeah, it's looking pretty good, I think. I think it's gonna look nice. We are gonna cut a couple slits in the carpet, obviously, so we have a nice, neat install as far as getting the wire into the amplifier itself. But yeah, I'm liking the way it's looking. I've got everything situated just about where I want it. The last thing I had to do was make a ground, and you can see my ground wire here. I'm actually gonna ground back here. I'm gonna go underneath the actual bolt, so this will sandwich down on it. So I think I'll probably take some of the paint off just so we make sure we get a good ground. But other than that, guys, I just need to rope the wire through there, and then we'll start on bringing the power wire from the front. So I did go ahead and vacuum this out, put the carpet back, but I haven't hooked the amp up yet. Obviously, we got to trim a little bit off each one of those, but I'm going to move to the bottom of the car. I did run a little tape along the edge of the piece that goes through the car, just in case. I mean, the grommet does protect it. I'm also going to be putting some loom on it. So at this point, we're going to get under here, and I'm going to run it just down the frame on this side, away from the exhaust. You can see, like I was talking about, the mufflers right there. We're far enough away from it, it's not gonna matter. But there are some lines. I believe these are fuel lines. I'm actually gonna put it in loom, and I'm gonna run it back behind the side steps here. So I think it should fit. I don't think we'll have any problem. But what I'll do is I'll put some loom on it first, and then we'll zip tie to it. And we're gonna come up right behind the fender liner here. So right here, we're gonna come up to the battery, which is right on that side. So you can see I've got it ran all the way down above the running boards, and it did fit with the loom on it. And I zip tied to the line right above it. And now I'm going to thread it up through the inner fender here and get it up to the top where we can hook it up. So for under the hood, like I said, I ran it up through the fender here, and I've got it actually tied to a line here because I couldn't find anywhere that I really wanted to mount it or drill a hole. But it's all hooked up. All I have to do is put the fuse in. But I'm ready to put the amp in the back, and you can see I put Velcro on the bottom. I haven't pulled the other side off yet, but that is what I'm going to use. Like I said, I know it's not the preferred method, but this will be contained. It's not going to move a bunch, and to be honest with you, that's how they keep the carpet down. So normally I would like to screw it to something, but because it'll probably come out if I ever sell this, I just didn't want to drill any more holes than I had to. So I'm going to go ahead, take this off, get it mounted, and then we'll hook up all the connections and see if it works. So only a couple things left to do, and that was I went ahead and put the fuse in here, and like I said, everything's hooked up here. I did trim on this a little bit so the wire could come out on the other side, but we're finished there. And then I got all the amp hookups arranged. Take a look at it here. Everything is nice and tucked in, looking nice, and it isn't going anywhere, which is good. And then obviously we had to hook into the box, which I mean, you guys probably have hooked up multiple stereo systems in your life. These speakers are actually all wired into one, so there's only one hookup, and that was here on the side. So the last thing we needed to do, or I still need to do actually, is this guy has a gain basically on your lead box that we put in line to grab the signal off of the Bose system. There's just a plug-in on the side of that box, which makes it really nice, to be honest with you, because not all the time do you want to just hammer, and sometimes you just want to listen to music without a ton of bass. Now, you could adjust it in the radio each time, but to me it's a little bit easier just to use this. So I've got to figure out a place to mount this. I'm not really sure where I'm going to put it. I really thought about putting it in the console because I don't think I'll be messing with it a bunch. And if you don't want to plug it in at all, it's just full gain all the time. So just so you guys know, if you don't want to use it, you don't have to. But I'm thinking, I really don't want to drill a hole in the dash to mount it. So I'll probably just drill a small hole right here and then run it through the actual glove box so I can just keep it in there. Because like I said, I really don't see me using it a ton, but when I don't want to hammer on the radio, then I have that option. So I'm gonna get that hooked up, get a hole drilled anyway, and then we will test it and see what it sounds like. I don't know how good the camera's gonna pick it up, but we'll see if it works nonetheless.
So I ran that wire through here, got everything back in place, and it's on the max. And they give you enough wire, you could go to the end of the earth, I feel like. But for now, I think that'll be a good place for it. So let's, because I am monetized, guys, we'll have to play a song on YouTube that's like no copyright. But let's see what it sounds like. It's not going to do it any justice in here, I'm sure.
Definitely hear it on the outside, that's for sure. We have to do some dyno matting. Oh, look at the windshield wiper. This thing's so dirty. Well, I won't play a ton of it because, like I said, YouTube just doesn't pick up. I mean, cameras don't. Any camera doesn't really pick up the audio. It's just not something that a GoPro's good at, but let me know what you guys think in the comments. You know, I know that these are some cheaper subs. Well, they actually weren't that cheap back in the day, but obviously used, you can find stuff a lot cheaper now. But let me know what your favorite stereo is. Like, I've been a fan of Kicker for a while. I don't really have a preference. I used to be a Rockford Fosgate guy when I first started getting into stereo, and then buddies of mine had Kicker and it all seemed to do really well. So I really don't have a preference as far as stereo is concerned. I like pretty much everything, but I know a lot of people like this new SCAR audio stuff. I've had some digital design stuff, which seems a little similar to the SCAR, but I don't know. Like I said, it's been so long since I got into the stereo game that I really don't know what's best. You guys are gonna have to give me some pointers when I go into a bigger stereo system that's going to be more permanent, maybe like in one of these builds that I'm doing. But if you guys did like this video, please, like always, smash that thumbs up button. It was a lot of fun, and I think the family's gonna enjoy bumping around. I think, like I said, maybe down the road, guys, give me some pointers on what you think I should put in that guy, the old 54, because we are gonna be cruising it a lot. I would like to do maybe an amp on not just the subs, but maybe on the mid-range and the tweeters as well. So, like I said, let me know what you think. While you're down there doing all that, guys, make sure you comment. But while you're down there commenting, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Of course, ring that bell icon that notifies you every single time we drop a new video. And stay tuned to see what we get into next.